So write down the problem or example. Write the grammar I hope you are able to see and listen me for generating strings over alphabet having A containing any that is zero or more number of A's and comment upon the language generated by this grammar. See, whatever question is asked, similarly you have to answer the question. So this is also important. Your comment is very important if this is asked in the paper. Okay, now if we are, so this is the example of what we are trying to write the, see, write the grammar. So it is the example of language to grammar. Earlier what we have seen, the grammar to language, but it is a language to grammar. Clear? So now how we will solve this problem, what is the solution and how to think. Now what do you understand from this problem? What will be the language? So language will be what? Having zero or more number of A's. What is the alphabet? Is having how many symbols? Only one symbol. So will it be a language like, if this is a alphabet and if this is the description of a language, so my language will be what? Zero or more, that means my language must have empty string. Zero or more means it will be a epsilon closure, we can say, of this summation or this alphabet. So it will be a language which will be like this. So actually we are interested in generating this language. So actually this comment we have to give after writing the grammar. But for our understanding, very first we need to understand what, for what language exactly we are required to write a grammar. Now from this language description and from the understanding of a grammar, what will be the first thing or which production you should have? So in the solution, very first we want to generate this particular string. How we can generate this string? That is an empty string. So empty string, that means in our set of rules or in a grammar, from the start symbol we should be able to generate the empty string, right? So which will be the first production? So very first case is zero number of A's can be derived, okay, using production. How we can generate? We can generate by using, so from start symbol, so it should be empty, okay. That is, we should have one production which is called as empty production in our grammar, without which you cannot generate this particular string. So this will be our first rule or first production, okay. Now second is, if we want one or more A's, okay, we can generate them using the production. Now how to think? What we want? Only A should be generated. If only A to be generated, okay, that means in the right hand side from the start symbol only A must be there. There should not be any scope to derive further, okay. For that case, what we are writing, we write A. So I can say I have generated one A from the given rule, right? Now what about if we want it to be recursive, right? After A, it should also replace or it should also generate all the strings 1, 2, 3 and so on. So for expressing generation of such language through a grammar, we should have some kind of recurrence, okay, or iteration we can say in the grammar. So in earlier example we have seen that in the left hand side the S was there and in the right hand side also there was a S. What it is indicating? That is indicating we are trying to replace the same start symbol in the next derivation as well. Similarly, here also we want that if there is a A, okay, we want the recurrence, that is we should be able to write A again. So if I write it like this, then what will be the case? It will be the case that for 1 and for, I can say it is, if I combine this rule and this rule, then I can even say it will be applicable to one or more, right? So here if I use this, what will happen? S produces AS, okay, my S is A. So second time when I will put this rule, so this is my second rule, this will be my third rule. So if I put or use rule 2 in the this after rule 3, what will happen? This S will be replaced by A and I will generate this particular string. Again, if I use this same rule in the same, that is rule 3 in a rule 3, then my string generated will be A, S and again S. I hope you are getting what I am trying to say. S produces AS. If I replace this S, this is using 3 rule. If I replace this S by A using 2, I am generating is A. Similarly, if I am having S produces AS, that is rule 3, and I am replacing here AS with the again rule 3, so it will become AS using rule 3, and now I will use AA and A. So here using rule 2, I am getting the string which is the third string. So from this observation we can say that if we go on replacing this S by either the same rule or this rule, we can generate all the strings, right? Now from this observation, if I combine all this, I can say my production sets or production rules for a given explanation of a language will be empty A and AS. Now the case is, so generally we write it as, we are generally writing in other way, that is S produces AS, A and empty is generally written at the end, okay. Now is it a minimized solution for a given grammar, or we can curtail some of the rules, we can minimize the number of rules which will explain the same language? Now see here, if I am having these 3 rules, I hope you are able to see, and if I am interested in generating the string, that is so I want to generate S, very first L is equal to L of G is equal to empty. So for this rule is must, or S produces empty is must. Now can I generate this A, okay, that is in my string language, there is a can I generate this a from this role only, that is s produces as using rule 3. So this is my rule 1, suppose this is 2 and rule 3. So very first I am using rule, which one? 1. Then if I replace this s with the rule 3, that is with the empty, okay, using rule 3, what will be my resultant string? My resultant string will be a, right? So we can say that I can derive the string a, okay, from which rule? 1 and 3 itself. I do not require extra rule, which is producing s produces a. Now if this is the case, then can I say that if I want to generate the next string, that is AA, will it be also possible by using the same three rules we can generate it? So S produces AS, again I am replacing A, S produces again AS, so using rule 3, again I am using 3, right? And then I am using AA empty. So which will be generating AA. So without using rule 2, I am able to generate all the strings, right? I have generated empty AAA and so on. I can generate from the only rules 1 and 3. So can we minimize this and we can write the final grammar as, so our grammar will be thus. We can represent the grammar as, G is equal to, see you have to write this in this form. How many non-terminals are there? Only one. How many terminals are there? It is having this two. Then how many production rules are there? So either I can write P or and describe the rules as down, or I can even write here like this in a bracket, S produces empty. So these are my P. And finally, what is my start symbol? My start symbol is S. So this is my V, this is my T, this is my P, and this is my S. Okay, so in this way we have tried to solve this problem. Now have we completed our discussion? We have to comment. They have written that you have to comment on the language. So you can comment as what? Which language it is generating? So it is generating language which is represented by a star. Can I say which is a what? It is a regular expression. So in short, we can try to relate regular expression with the language. So from all this discussion we can say that we can write a grammar as well for the regular languages. Okay, so you have to write a comment as what? We can denote a language which is generated or represented by a star, okay, which is having zero or more number of a's. So again I think this is clear to you.